At this point, we can go a step further. You already understand that a variable is just a name that carries a number, and you can create as many names as you want just by writing something like k is equal to 5. So we can try to solve one more problem in order to understand the power of just using variables. The goal is to take any 3-digit number and show the numbers it consists of. More specifically, if you have the number 482, the computer needs to show 4, 8 and 2. As always, you can pause this video for a minute and try to solve this problem on your own. We already assume that we have a 3-digit number. We can try to separate it in steps. First, we can try to extract the first number. An interesting idea is to divide the number with 100. So for example, if the user gives you 457, you will have as a result 4,57. Or if the user gives you 123, you will have as a result 1,23. So if we try to extract only the integer part of the number 4,57, we will get the number 4. Now we need to find a way to repeat the same procedure. An idea is to subtract the first digit. So for that, you need to subtract from the number 456 the number 400, or from the number 123 the number 100, and you will have the result 56 and 23. It is easy to guess that the equation is number minus first digit multiplied by 100. Then, if you understand this concept, it is very easy to create the rest of the code. More specifically, for the first example, now you have the number 56. So first you will divide with the number 10 and take the integer part, which is the number 5. And then you will subtract from the number 56 the number 5 multiplied by 10. So you will get the number 6. As you can see here, we succeed to take the number 6, 5 and 4. In the case that you didn't understand, feel free to watch again this part of the video. Let's try to create this into code. First, we will initialize the number that is equal to 396. Then we need the first digit. So first is equal to integer, because we need the integer part of our number divided by 100, as we already talked about in the analysis. And here we can print the result. So if the code is correct so far, we will have the number 3. Okay, everything is correct. Now we will take the number and subtract the digit, the first digit, that is multiplied by 100. Only for the debug, we can print the number. Now here we want to have the number 96. Okay, again everything is correct. The second digit is again equal to the integer part of the number that now we have divided by 10. We can again print the second digit. And the third digit is equal to the number that we have minus the second multiplied by 10, as we already talked about in the previous section of the code. And we will print the result. Okay, 396. We can use some other numbers. 134, 134, 987, 987. Okay, everything is correct.